Second rule, the FCC called it the no throttling rule. And I suggest you forget that term immediately, because what they really meant to say is you should not discriminate against applications. What does discrimination mean? It means making certain applications work better than others. For example, you might slow down certain applications that you don't like, or you can speed up applications whom you want to give you an advantage. If you think back to an electricity example, it's as if the microwave was still working, but some microwaves would work better with electricity than others. Why do we need that kind of rule? Well, first, if you only have a rule against blocking, but no rule against discrimination, that makes the rule against blocking meaningless. If you have ever used Skype or the phone functionality of WhatsApp, you know what happens if delay increases past a certain level. You speak, the other person speaks, you both pause, you both come back at the same time, and at some point the telephony application just becomes unusable. So discrimination is just another tool to give some applications an advantage over others, and if you prohibit blocking but allow discrimination, then ISPs can just engage in discrimination. The second question is, well, what kind of discrimination should we ban? Should we ban any kind of discrimination? Do ISPs have to treat every packet the same? Or are there more nuanced solutions? And the solution that the FCC adopted, which I think is the right solution, is to say the following. As an internet service provider, you're not allowed to discriminate against applications. That means you're not allowed to pick a single or several applications within a class of applications and treat them differently. So, you can't say I speed up Skype, but I slow down WhatsApp. Those are similar applications. You can't do that. But the FCC also said you cannot distinguish among different classes of applications. So, you cannot slow down all online video applications. You cannot slow down all online telephony applications. If you look at this rule, you might say, yeah, the first one is pretty intuitive. You know, clearly if I speed up Skype and I slow down WhatsApp, I get exactly this problem of picking winners and losers, the distortion of competition. But if I just treat all applications in the same way, where's the harm? There is no distortion of competition. But it turns out that internet service providers still do have incentives to single out whole classes of applications. And actually, most of the stories and instances of discrimination that we have seen are discriminations against whole classes of applications. In the US, Comcast was found to interfere with all peer-to-peer file sharing applications, not just with BitTorrent. When mobile internet service providers prohibited the use of online telephony, they didn't say, oh, you can use Skype but not the others. No, they blocked all of them. So now from the perspective of the user, I don't care whether the application provider just blocks or discriminates against my favorite application or all applications in the class. Blocking all applications in the class is actually worse for me because now I can't even switch to another one. And from the perspective of the application provider, it's exactly the same thing. Do you think my investor is any more happy if I say, don't worry that I'm being excluded and I can't get to my users? All my competitors are in the same boat? No, of course not. They care about your application getting to users. And so just because it's the whole class doesn't make it any better. So that means, as a regulator, you need to be very careful that you don't just capture the first case, but also the second.